Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjaliyammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Koyilvanni. I am happy to meet you in the video lecture series on the subject Engineering Thermodynamics. And we are discussing Module 5, Properties of Steam. And this is the third lecture on Properties of Steam. So we recap from the previous two lectures. So we discussed the formation of the steam and its thermodynamic properties. Wet steam property, dry steam property, and superheated steam properties we discussed, and we introduced the steam table and the Mollier chart for calculating, for taking the properties of the steam, and we discussed the PV diagram, PT diagram, TV diagram, temperature entropy diagram, enthalpy entropy diagram of the steam and PVT surface, and the use of the steam table Mollier chart also we have discussed. And in this lecture, so we will discuss on the thermodynamic process with the steam, and the learning outcome for the students at the end of the lecture, the student will be able to draw the PV and TS diagram of thermodynamic process, calculate the work done and heat transfer in the thermodynamic process. So the various process, thermodynamic process that we are going to discuss in this lecture, they are isochoric or constant volume process, isobaric or constant pressure process, isothermal process or constant temperature process, reversible adiabatic process or isentropic process, and the polytropic process. So all these processes also we discussed all these processes earlier with the perfect gas. So with the air or the perfect gas as the working medium, now here the working substance is steam. That is the difference. Otherwise, we have to apply the first law. All the equations are very much applicable. The only difference is earlier lecture we used the gas as the working substance. So here we are using the water vapor or steam as the working substance. And the first process is constant volume heating process. So we have to draw the pressure volume and temperature entropy diagram. So first the pressure volume diagram. So the line, the curved line is the saturation line. So the saturated liquid line. So here we have the critical point and we have the saturated vapor line, and it is heating. So initially the steam is wet. So one is wet steam. Upon heating, the quality of the steam increases and it becomes superheated steam. So it is constant volume heating. So in the PV diagram, we have a vertical line. So one is the wet steam. When you add heat energy, the quality of the steam is increasing, and at the end of the heating process, the steam becomes superheated steam. And in the temperature entropy diagram, again we have the saturation line. So the saturated liquid line, here we have the critical point and we have the saturated vapor line. So again the initial condition is wet steam here, and the constant volume line, it goes like this. So for 1 to A, so it is up to saturation point, from A to 2 is in the superheated region. So after heating process, the steam becomes superheated steam. And we have to calculate. So it is a constant volume vessel. So the amount of steam, it is a closed system. All the processes are closed system. The mass of the steam in the closed vessel. So M equal to V1, volume V1 divided by the specific volume X1 into VG1. So X1 into VG1, that is the specific volume of the wet steam. Because initially it is wet steam. X1 VG1 is the specific volume of the wet steam. So here in the constant volume process, work done equal to 0, we calculate change in enthalpy per kg of the steam, delta H equal to H2 minus H1. So we have to calculate the H1, H2, depending on this, H1 enthalpy of the wet steam, H2 enthalpy of the superheated steam, S1 enthalpy of the wet steam, S1 entropy of the wet steam, S2 entropy of the superheated steam. So all these values we have to calculate using the basic formula of steam properties. Then we have to calculate the change in enthalpy delta H equal to H2 minus H1. The change in internal energy per kg of the steam, U2 minus U1 equal to H1 minus P2 V2. So U2 equal to H2 minus P2 V2 and U1 equal to H1 minus P1 V1. So rearranging the term, U2 minus U1 equal to H2 minus H1 minus P2 V2 minus P1 V1. So, knowing the value of enthalpy from the previous equation, we can calculate the change in internal energy, and the heat transfer during the process. Applying the first law of thermodynamics, Q equal to W plus delta U. So, since W equal to 0, so amount of heat transfer equal to U2 minus U1. And the relationship between pressure, volume, temperature, so V1 equal to V2 here. So, volume is constant. So, for wet steam, it is X1 VG1. For dry steam, sorry, superheated steam, VG2 into T2 by TS2. So, this is the relationship. So, from this equation, you can find out the unknown. So, even for the perfect gas, the delta H equal to H2 minus H1, delta U equal to U2 minus U1, Q equal to W plus delta U. So, all the equations are very much similar, but you have to calculate the properties of the steam. So, H1, H2, U1, U2, the calculations are differing from the gases. Otherwise, the equations for calculating various parameters are very much similar with the perfect gas. And a constant pressure heating process. So, the pressure remains constant. Once again, we draw the PV diagram. So, initially 0.1. So, it is wet steam. So, upon heating, it becomes superheated steam. So, horizontal line represents the pressure P1 equal to P2. So, the area under this PV diagram is the work done. So, initially wet steam. When you heat, it will become superheated steam. When the reverse process, when you cool the steam at constant pressure, the quality of the steam will decrease. Maybe superheated steam at the beginning, by cooling, it becomes wet steam. So, when you heat, the quality of the steam increases, both in constant volume and constant pressure. When you cool, the quality of the steam decreases from the superheated steam to the wet steam. Then the temperature entropy diagram. So, the constant the pressure process. So, initially the line from in the wet region, it is horizontal line. Then the line is inclined. So, A to 2 is the superheated heating in the superheated region. 1 to A is the heating in the wet region. So, this is saturated vapor liquid line, critical point we have, and then we have the saturated vapor line. So, this is the temperature entropy diagram for constant volume heating, constant pressure heating process. Then work done here, area under this diagram, it is the area of this rectangle. So, V2 minus U1 into this height equal to P. So, P into V2 minus U1 is the work done during the constant pressure process. The change in enthalpy per kg of the steam, so delta H equal to H2 minus H1, and the change in internal energy per kg of the steam, U2 minus U1 equal to H2 minus P2 V2 minus H1 minus P1 V1. So, because U2 equal to H2 minus P2 V2 and U1 equal to H1 minus P1 V1, and rearranging the term, U2 minus U1 equal to H2 minus H1 minus P2 V2 minus P1 V1 kilojoules per kilogram, and the amount of heat transfer here. So, Q equal to W plus delta U. So, the W equal to P2 V2 minus P1 V1 minus U2 minus U1. So, P2 V2 minus P1 V1 plus H2 minus H1 minus P2 V2 minus P1 V1. So, this U2 minus U1 from the previous equation is substituted here. So, this P2 V2 minus P1 V1 minus P2 V2 minus P1 V1, that is getting cancelled. So, finally, the amount of heat transfer equal to Q equal to H2 minus H1 kilojoules per kilogram. So, all the calculations, remember, it is again the equations are very much similar to the perfect gas equation. Only difference is you have to take the properties of the steam here, depending on the condition, whether this is wet steam, dry steam or superheated steam. Based on the quality of the steam, we have to find out the property of the steam. And isothermal expansion process. So, constant temperature expansion process. So, once again, one is in the wet region. When you expand the steam, so we have to add heat energy. When you expand the steam, the quality increases. So, after expansion, the quality here it is 2, which is superheated region. So, this is look at the temperature entropy diagram. Temperature is constant. So, when you expand, so T1 to T2, it is horizontal line for constant temperature. And finally, after expansion, it becomes superheated steam. So, one is the wet steam and two is superheated steam. So, this is the PV diagram for isothermal process. This is the temperature entropy diagram for isothermal process. And for isothermal process, PV equal to constant. Because P1 V1 equal to P2 V2. This is the condition for isothermal process. So, the work done, already we derived derived the work done for perfect gas. The same equation we can apply here. Work done per kg of the steam W equal to P1 into small V1 specific volume logarithmic of small V2 by capital small V1. So, the volume ratio of the isothermal expansion process. and the heat transfer per kg of the steam. So Q equal to, from the first law of thermodynamics, delta U plus W, so U2 minus U1 plus P1 U1 logarithmic of U2 by V1, and here this U2 equal to H2 minus P2 V2, and U1 equal to H1 minus P1 U1 into P1 U1 logarithmic of V2 by V1. Now P2 V2 equal to P1 U1, so these two are cancelled, so the P2 V2 and P1 U1, they are cancelled, then it becomes Q equal to H2 minus H1 plus P1 V1 into logarithmic of V2 by V1. So the amount of heat transfer in the isothermal process is Q equal to delta H into the work done, P1 U1 into logarithmic of V2 by V1. Then we take the reversible adiabatic process or isentropic process. So the PV to the power gamma equal to constant here, or simply we remember it is isentropic process, and this process is very important for all our vapor power cycles. And here it is compression, adiabatic compression, so the pressure increases. So one is the wet steam, when you compress, so it becomes two superheated steam. So for the compression, you have the vertical line, so one is in the wet region, two is in the superheated region. So the work done for the reversible adiabatic process, whether for non-flow isentropic process, W equal to Q plus U2 minus U1, so Q equal to 0, so this W equal to U2 minus U1 for flow isentropic process. So I mean, what is non-flow process? It is a piston cylinder arrangement, flow process with open system, so our turbine or the compressor. So turbine steam turbine is the device where you have the flow process, isentropic process. So W equal to H2 minus H1. A pump is also isentropic flow process, where you have to calculate W equal to H2 minus H1. Then polytropic process. So PV to the power N equal to constant. So for polytropic process, PV to the power N equal to constant. So here again, polytropic compression process mentioned here. So one is in the wet region, two is in the superheated region. So when you compress the steam polytropically, the quality of the steam increases, and the expansion, when you expand the steam polytropically, the quality of the steam decreases. So here again, look at the temperature entropy diagram. So one is the wet steam, two is the superheated steam. So this is 1 to 2 is the compression process. 2 to 1 is the expansion, polytropic expansion process. Then work done here. So the equation what we used for the perfect gas, W equal to P1 V1 minus P2 V2 divided by N minus 1. And the heat transfer per kg of the steam, W equal to delta U, U2 minus U1 plus W. So W equal to P1 U1 minus P2 V2 divided by N minus 1. So U2 equal to H2 minus P2 V2, and U1 equal to H1 minus P1 U1 plus P1 V1 minus P2 V2 divided by N minus 1. So rearranging the terms, so this is H2 minus H1, I take plus P1 V1 minus P2 V2 plus P1 V1 minus P2 V2 divided by N minus 1. So in the second term and the third term, we have P1 V1 minus P2 V2 as a common parameter. So H2 minus H1 plus P1 V1 minus P2 V2 multiplied by 1 plus 1 by N minus 1. And simplifying this will give you N by N minus 1. So work done for the polytropic process, which is H2 minus H1 into N by N plus 1 into P1 V1 minus P2 V2. That is the work done. Or simply using this equation, first equation, so we can calculate the work done for the polytropic process. So depending on the quality of the steam, the value of the parameter or the equation for calculating various thermal properties, internal energy, entropy, enthalpy, specific volume, everything is changing. So that is where you have to be very careful on calculating the properties of the steam. And here again, we have to take the properties of the steam at the given pressure and temperature from the steam table. That is also very important. So you have to take the properties from the steam table for a given pressure and temperature, then we have to calculate the various parameters of the steam. And these are all the reference books I used for preparing the slides. You can also refer to it for additional information, and you can write to my mail ID for any queries or clarification. Thank you for watching, and we will meet again.